Hello everyone, this is Hong. Today we'll be talking about an AngularJS application which I've learned at a course at codeschool.com, and the course is free. The course is called Shaping Up with AngularJS. It's really helpful. So here I'm showcase the app that I've built by the end of the course. And I highly recommend that you take the course as well. I'll give the link in the comment in the video. So today we're going to showcase these things. First one is we start up a local server for the directory. The reason for that is that due to security reasons, we cannot access the file system directly. That won't work for the Angular.js or any JavaScript related libraries. And then we'll showcase the application. What does the application do? And then we'll explain the application piece by piece. First, we'll explain the index.html, and we'll explain the JavaScript files. And then we'll explain the other template HTML files. Alright, so let's begin. First thing is we want to start a server. One of the easy ways is to use this Python module. Just say python-m simple HTTP server and the port name. Any port name less than 1024 needs root privilege, but 1024 is good. So we just start that. It started. And when I refresh the page, it shows up the app. So that's good. And then let me showcase the application. The application is for a gem store where which sells different types of gems. I only have one here, but later on we'll see that we have more than one. It has the name of the gem, its price, a description, an image, and it has a tab. First, tab one is description, again, a description. Second tab is specs. It has shine, faces, rarity, color. And third one is reviews. Reviews is a big chunk of this app where we have existing reviews formatted with stars, a review and an author and also the date. And this part is a live preview where the AngularJS has its power of 2-way data binding. We will see that in a second. And then we have this submit review form and the submit button. So let's try it out. Notice the star and the context here, this part, live preview. When I select 5, it changes to 5, 3 to 3, so on and so forth. And have a comment shows up red there when I type that in, and it does have some validation on this email input. When I say Jeff, it won't show up. This is considered to be a valid email address, but that's another story to add that. So it does have something for the email address validation. And if everything is good, we submit it. After submitting, you'll notice that these becomes red and this is green. The red is because these are required fields, and the green is because it's not required. So we if we change that to something, it becomes green. So that's it for the showcase of the application. We'll talk about the application itself piece by piece. Hello again. In this session, we'll talk about the index.html, and this index.html might be different from what you have seen before. First of all, we have this, we used a lot of ng annotations on the element, on the HTML elements. So first thing we see is this ng app annotation, where it says this is a Angular application named store. And after that, we have our head, which has two CSS files. The first one is bootstrap one. Second one is styles.css. Let's check that one. It's really quick. Note that still this has to do with the Angular invalid and valid and dirty CSS attributes. And basically says if the element is dirty and invalid, make the border color to red. And if it's dirty but valid, if it's the data is changed and it is a valid data, then we set the border color to this one, which is slightly green. So that's it for the CSS. And that's not so much magic going on. Here at the body session, we have this ng controller, which says store controller as store. Store controller is something we defined in one of our JavaScript files. And this store as store, the store in as store is the alias of the store controller. So we have a hold of the store, and after that, we're about to use the store. So here we reference it as store.products. And basically, it references the add product in the store. And we have this ng repeat directive, which is like a loop for each of the product in store.products. So essentially store.products are is a array, and we loop through each element in this array. And we also have this pipe expression followed by this filter. And this filter is a limit to filter. We only are interested in the first five elements. And this dev will have the first five elements in the store dot products and object. Okay, so I have a hold of the product, and we're going to use it. So we just use just product.name with these curly brackets. And these curly brackets are used for expressions in Angular. And next one is product.price. Product price is then filtered by this currency, which formats the price accordingly. And then we have this product.descriptions, similar with the product.name. So far, so good. And the next part is really some bit of magic here. These are called custom directives. And for the first one, product-gallery, we'll have a custom directive called product gallery. We'll see it later on. Similarly, we have this product dash tabs, which we will have a product tabs custom directives. After that, we have a button. Our button shows only, we have this ng show keyword where it only shows when the expression is equal to true. And the expression we're interested in are product.canPurchase. So that's it. And the rest of it are JavaScripts, including first one is angular.min.js. That's Angular. And the bottom two ones are our code. All right, so let's play with this number and see how it affects the our application. So as we said before, we have a limit of 5. Let's change that to 1 and load the page again. It shows only 1 gem in the store. And we see the product name is My Precious Gem. Product price is 5.25. And product description is This is My Precious Gem. And we will see why we have this image and why we have this tab later on when we see the rest of the code. So here we are at the we'll explain the application with regard to its JavaScript part. We have two JavaScript files. One is app.js and the other is products.js. We have already included that in our index.html, and let's see what's in that. The first thing you notice in this app.js is that it's using angular.module, and the module name is store, and it has a dependency called store products. We'll talk about that later, but for now just thinks that the store products are actually this file. Is the module defined in this file, to be accurate. And after that, we have this app.controller. We have a hold of the Angular module of store, and we use app.controller, and we are specifying a controller named store controller. And I couldn't figure this part out, but basically we want to do something similar to the review controller. So let's explain the review controller first. So we have app.controller, and we have the name of the controller as review controller, and it has a function, and what it does is that it that's the logic for the review. For the review, this is we'll talk about later. Let's talk about the product store controller. Essentially, we only want to initialize the products as the gems, and gems is a big JSON object. Defined later on. So there's nothing more, there's no more inside this store controller. And the gems, as we already see, you may already have guessed that this is mapped to the name, price, description, etc. So each of these this is a JSON array, and each of the elements in the array is has a name, a price, a description, and can purchase. If you recall, can purchase defines that whether this whether there will be a button showing or not. It has sold out, and these parts are from shine, faces, rarity, and color are the specs of the gem. We'll see here, shine, faces, rarity, and color. And it has an array of images. So far, so good. And we also have reviews here. Reviews inside the product object is in itself a array, and each of them is one review. Each of the review has stars, body, author, and created on date. And you can see for the first one, we have the first stars five stars. Body, I love this gem. Author, by this author, and on a specific date. The second review is similar to that. So let's talk about the review controller then. The review controller is defines behavior in this review, and you can imagine that when we hit the button submit review, what would happen? First of all, we want to set the review the initial value of review to an empty object, and later on when we hit the button, this method will be called the add review, and it is passed in the product is passed in as a parameter, and inside this one, because we only have stars, description, or review rather, and author, we only have these, we are actually create the created on date on the fly, in that we create this review object, reference this review object, and use this created on date, and assign that to date now, and we refer the products.reviews, and we put this review. And then we clear this review. So the review here is here. Initially, we want the initial review to be empty, so don't have anything here. And after we submit hit, after we hit the submit button, it should also be cleared out. So clear it out. Let's play with the can purchase property just to verify the logic we said before. So if it is set to true, we refresh the page. See the reviews. Refresh again, it shows this add to cart. It says back to false, the button does not show up. Hello again, and we're about to talk about the products.js, the second JavaScript file in our project. So the products.js has a bunch of stuff. First of all, it is it defines a Angular module named store products, which is used here, store products, by the main app. And because we are defining a different module, the app is different with the other app we have seen before. And then we use this app.directive to define custom directives. There are a few types of them. Type E means element directive, and type A means attribute directive. And we can also specify the controller as well. So we'll start with the easy ones. So we say app.directive and give the name of the directive to be product description. And the template for that here is product-description. Notice the matching of the cases. This is product-description. This is product capital description. This is camera case. And then after that, we give a function which simply returns this object, this object. And this will be used. We are essentially creating a product-description custom directive, which is being used somewhere in our file. Similarly, we define a product specs directive, and it's a attribute directive, and its template is it uses product.specs.html, which we will talk about later on. Actually, let's talk about these for a second. This product-description is this part, and this product.specs is this part. We'll go to the description. You can imagine what is there. It's really simple. It says description, and it has a product.description. Notice that we already have a hold of the product in our controller, or actually here in our index.html. And we can refer to the product.description similar with this line, and we show it. Similarly, for the specs tab, we have this product.specs, and it is a list of the shine, faces, variety, color of the product, and we simply put the print out the attribute one by one. So here, after defining the product.description and the product.specs custom directives, we define two more directives, and this time we are using controller in these directives. First one is product tabs. Product tabs is a element directive. It uses this product-tabs.html, which has a whole bunch of things. Let's jump back. It has a controller, and the syntax is that the controller is an anonymous function, and it does these things. And we have this controller as panel. Controller as, and we specify an alias panel. For this part, we have the controller. It uses a tab variable, and initially we are setting it to 1. 1 means it is this, the first tab. And we have two more functions in this function, in this controller. One is select tab, which simply set the tab value to the tab value passed in, and the other is setSet, which returns a boolean true or false whether the passed in tab is the current tab. It's whether the passed in tab is the tab that is being that is selected. Whether the passed in tab is a selected tab. And then, similarly, we define this product gallery directive. And it is an element directive again. And this template is this product.gallery. And this controller is this function which says the current initialize that to 1 and set current to be either the value that passed in, or if it's not defined, then set that to 0. And this controller is named gallery. Let's check out the product.gallery template. The product.-gallery defines this. So it defines a dev with image. I might have something wrong here, but essentially we want to have this ng source on this image element. We don't want to use source because that one will be evaluated when the page get rendered, and you won't see the image. And here the image source is the image, the product.images and the gallery.current. So for the current product, the images array in this product, and we are referencing the gallery.current. Recall that we have this gallery current, and we are referencing that. So essentially that will be 0. Hello again. We talked about product-description, product-specs, product-gallery, and we are going to talk about the final piece of it, the product-tab. The product-tab contains the tabs and the review part here. First of all, how we are going to define the behavior here. As I click on the tab, it shows the content of the tab. Well, that part is easy because we are using Bootstrap. We first have list elements here, and we have, instead of each element, have an anchor, it's ref, and it has different contents as description, specs, and reviews. Second of all, we click on the link. it will simply call the panel.select tab with the corresponding number. First tab is 1, second tab is 2, and third tab is 3. And we are only showing the tab. It is only active when the tab is set to a certain number. For the first one, we are only showing it when the panel dot is set 1 equals to 2. So it only shows up when the first tab is selected. Same thing for the second and third tab. And this select tab and its set are defined in our panel here, where we have this controller, where we have this custom directive of product tabs. And the controller, we initially have it as 1, but I set it to 3. And the select tab is, as we talked about, it just set the tab to the value it passed in, and its set is simply checking whether it's equals to the passed in tab name. So if I change that to 1 and reload the page, we would expect that description tab is shown. That is the case. Okay, let's move on. So after the tabs logic, we want the content of the tabs. We talked about the product dash description, the product dash description as a custom directive. And we also have the product dash specs as a another custom directive, which is an attribute directive in this case. So that's how you do that, as a attribute directive. And these two are easy. It only shows up, we're using ng show again to specify, okay, only when the panel is set to 1 or 2 or 3 will the corresponding content be shown. For the review part, is a big chunk, but we can break that down into pieces. First of all, it has a review context, and then we loop through all the product.reviews for each of the review. We repeat for each of the review. We show this number of stars, the content, the body of the review, the author of the review, and also the created on date, which is piped to a filter of date. So as you can see, Joe at example.org on such date. So that part is all good. Then we have the form. As from this part to this part, including the button. The form itself is named as review form. It has a controller. The review controller is defined in the app.js, and is we've defined a method called addReview. We talked about it sets the created on and add the review to the reviews. And then with this review controller review control, we set the ng submit. And here's the tricky part. First of all, we want to disable the HTML5 validate, so no validate. So that disables the HTML5 validate. And then we use our Angular validate, which we have ng-submit. And we say, okay, I want the review form is valid. Only when the review form is valid, and dollar sign valid is something comes with Angular. Only when that is valid, will we add the review. Will we call the add review on the review controller and pass in the product. And then comes the live review part, this part. So first of all, similarly, as we are using the controller, we say review control dot review dot stars, this number of stars. And we use review control dot review dot body to show the body similarly. And then we have review other. Again, these three parts are mapped to the ng model keyword. We have ng model review control review stars, review control review body, and review control review author. So that binds, the two-way binding comes in place where we select a number or type in some text. It will show up immediately here. So that's the live preview part. And then we have finally come to the review form. First of all, we have submit a review. And then we have a bunch of field set. But in essence, the first one is ng model. The stars in the review controller, and this use ng options stars four stars in 5 4 3 2 1, and that is this, and this is used an it has an option with empty value. I read this product, so if I reload this page, select to review. Read the product with these numbers. And the second one is the ng model review controller dot review dot body with a placeholder. And the last piece is the email field set input review control dot review dot author. And then finally, we have the submit button. If you see, another thing we want to point out is that the stars is required, and the author is also required. So if I don't select those, I only gave the text, I won't be able to submit it. When you click submit, it fails right here when it checks review form dot valid, that equals to false, and I won't be able to add that. If I have something here but not valid, still cannot submit. If I have something valid, I remove that because that's optional. I can submit that. That's it for everything. Today we talked about my project following the code school shaping up with AngularJS project. I showcase that we start a local server from the directory to get around the security restrictions. We showcase the application itself, which we're seeing here. And we explain each piece of the application bit by bit. That's it for today. Thanks for watching.